Doo-wop, shoo-wop, oh, doo-wop, shoo-wop, doo-wop, shoo-wop, oh, doo-wop, shoo-wop, doo-wop, shoo-wop, oh, doo-wop, shoo-wop, boop, boop.
Hi everyone, and welcome back to Ponytail Journal's Tastiest Life Possible, where I show you that cooking is not something to be afraid of, super fun, and will bring you much deliciousness. Now today, I have a stack of stale bread that's left over from my market stall on the weekend. So, being the nifty little girl I am, I'm going to make French toast for breakfast using this old bread, which will taste super delicious. Now for this here recipe, you will need one bowl, some raw honey, some stale bread, two raw organic eggs, some sea salt, some bananas because we're going to make stuffed French toast, some milk, and some vanilla bean paste or vanilla essence. So what you want to do is crack your eggs into your bowl, just like that, and then what we're going to do is add a pinch of salt, about half a teaspoon of vanilla bean paste, and about a good heap teaspoon of the raw honey. And that raw honey is for me. Now we're just going to beat and add our milk. Not too thick, but it's not too watery either. Now let's just put a piece of our stale old bread right in there to let it soak in so that we have a super soft French toast at the end. Just give him a little flip over when one side is completely soaked in.
Melt some butter in a hot pan and slide your slippery French toast into that pan face down. Lower the heat a little bit to medium, and now place your other piece of toast into your egg mixture. After a couple of minutes, flip it over, and then you can drain it slightly and put it into your pan to accompany your other piece. Once it's cooked on one side, flip it over, and the other piece can get a flip too. Banana will add extra deliciousness, so I like to place mine on the bigger piece, and it goes straight onto your plate, followed by the smaller piece to just give it a hat. And now it's ready for serving. So add some more grass-fed butter onto your French toast to seal the deal, and finally pure maple syrup to sweeten things up a little bit. Your French toast should be slightly chewy and very soft.
Waste not, want not, my fantastic French toast using my stale bread left over from my market stall on the weekend. A very good lesson in using every last bit. For my recipe and many other goodies, go to ponytailjournal.com where you can shop my tables, shop my looks, and follow my funnest life possible. And for you Instagrammers and Twitterers, you can follow me at ponytailjournal. And don't forget to tag me in your photos because I want to see your skills too. And finally, for you Facebook lovers, I am also on Facebook, Ponytail Journal. Until next time, happy eating.
Subscribe.